Warning. Lead is neurotoxic. Wear gloves when handling it. Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to test for lead using the potassium rhodizonate we made in a previous video. First, get about 0.3 grams of potassium rhodizonate and add to it 100 milliliters of 5% acetic acid solution, also known as vinegar. Try and dissolve as much as you can. Now get a sheet of filter paper and wet it with our solution. This is our test paper and must be freshly made as the rhodizonate decays after about an hour. Now to test for lead. I have here a single piece of lead shot. Rubbing it into the filter paper, it leaves behind these brown to purple splotches of lead rhodizonate, showing that the shot really is made of lead. Now I have here a funnel that was used to filter a lead-containing solution. And although it was cleaned, let's see if we can still detect lead on it. Not much on the outside. What about the inside? And there it is. The purple color shows there is a trace but detectable amount of lead still in the funnel. Looks like it's going to need some more cleaning. Let's try something more common now. I have here some lead-based solder. It's hard to see, but the label says it's made of 63% tin and 37% lead. Let's rub the test paper, and there we go. A clear positive for lead. Now let's try this lead-free solder, which is 95% tin and 5% antimony. Rubbing the test paper, we can see no trace of lead, as expected from a lead-free solder. Now before you go running off and testing everything for lead, I still recommend using a proper commercial lead testing kit. I'll show you why. This is a sample of lead-based paint I was able to obtain. I'm certain it contains lead, but when tested with our test paper, there is no clear color change. I don't know exactly what's wrong. Maybe I need a better test solution, or the paint has some additives that gives false negatives for lead, or the paint is simply too insoluble. But in any case, a false negative can mislead you into a false sense of safety. If you're unsure about something and really need to know, then send a sample to a commercial analytical testing lab. Nonetheless, for our purposes of testing soluble lead salts and metals in later videos, this solution will be enough. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, and comment.